Code Realize, Wintertide Miracles. Oh my, oh my. You can choose it for each individual. So if you want someone to speak softer or louder, Alistair. Van Helsing, Lupin. Omnibus. Many familiar names. Quick save and load. Get to now. Cardia. There's no space. Sure. That's a triangle. Go on a date with two characters who strike your fancy. You can even choose from a few folks outside of Lupin's crew. Who will you choose? An alternate story based on the events that transpired after Finn's route in the previous game, Future Blessings. I'm guessing Finn's is the previous main character. A story about what happened after Finn's route from the previous game. I guess let's find out what happened to the previous main character. Who are you? Dore, das ka. Dore anata. Sore boku wa. Biological terminals. So they're all dolls? ISIS terrorist plot. So Code Realize must have been the first game where all this happened. Eternal Global Warfare. Now Tilius after. A battleship. The profile of a mad scientist. To be a human. Now the story starts. Beautiful weather today. A fine day for hanging laundry. Maybe I can increase the text speed. So it's been 6 months since Father and his insanity disappeared into the sky. It's odd. Only a few years ago, I was alone in this mansion, with my arms around my knees. The mansion was a complete mess when we first arrived here, when we returned. Windows were broken, walls were covered in ivy, cobwebs infested every corner. Parts of the floors and walls were burnt black, and some still were crumbling apart. Back then, this was all normal to me, but upon returning, I could only describe this place as an abandoned ruins. So for the better part of a year since coming back here, I've been spending most of my time fixing it up. Climbing atop of the roof with Finis, patching up holes, plastering the crumbled walls, patching each hole in the floorboards. Even my own personal quarters was moved to one of the renovated ones. My original room that was filled with dolls is left intact, but it brings back such a dramatic mix of feelings. Not to mention, sunlight always did have a trouble finding its way in here and there. There's plenty to be proud of with all the work we've done here. This living room, however, has changed quite a bit from before. When we returned, it was filled with spiders' webs and caked with dust. But after some thorough cleaning and getting the necessary furniture bit by bit, it now represents the best of our efforts as placed here that feels cozy and welcoming. I can't help but feel proud when I look around and imagine how dusty it used to be. If I didn't know any better, I think this house was always like this. It certainly shouldn't be embarrassing to have friends over now, I hope. So it doesn't like Lupin and MP in pay, but gets along with Shirley and Deli. A photograph of a family that used to live here, all smiling warmly. A photograph from a long, long time ago. Father, mother, with your permission, may I invite friends over every now and then? All materials relating to Isaac are supposed to be valuable, confidential documents of the British Empire. As such, they're required to be securely stored in the underground archives of Buckingham Palace. However, I was given special permission by the Queen to take possession of both this photo and an old diary. Suddenly, an exasperated voice, standing at the living room entrance, with his arm crossed, is a young man who resembles an older version of the boy in the photo. My only remaining family member. Finish. That's the younger brother. I swear, sister, why must you be so careless with time all the time? A brief morning tea, which typically serves us refreshment after one's morning working duties or studies. the heroine's little brother, who was hostile to her at first, but in overcoming a series of incidents has become family in the truest sense. Bickering like a couple. It's only partially repaired. We're gonna execute our secret plan, which is to grow our own vegetables in our home garden. That's the plan, anyways. Living room. Hansel and Saint Germain. A mysterious organization headed by a woman named Omnibus. They fashion themselves as overseer of history and claim to guide the path of humanity. Idea. Shall we wait in her bed? I'd really prefer if you didn't. Oh, do you two like jelly muffins? They're supposed to keep tab on us. Yeah, so it's a usual occurrence. At least once a month. I think we already have traps. Many traps. Pencil is a bit dense. This feels more like an epilogue, where you should have played the first story to better enjoy this one. The top among the top 10 delinquents. Her team members. Are there only 13 apostles? How do they determine the ranks? Life here in Wales is surprisingly tranquil. So tranquil, in fact, that sometimes I believe we're the only ones existing in this world. It's a comfortable old-fashioned lifestyle surrounded by only trees, forests, and animals. As I've said before, I'm quite content with our happy daily lives here. But if there's one problem I could point to, shopping is short, is inconvenient, isn't it? 2 hours by car to the nearest town. I know I always complain about this, but it's too far. One of these days, you need to tell me exactly what kind of image of you you have of me. Crash? No. Just speeding up. Accelerator. Where's the conflict or the gameplay? Ah.